here. We're over here at the Mill Street property, and I'm going to make a set of shutters for the front two windows of this house, and I want to stain them the color we stained all the woodwork on the front of the house. So we're trying to give it that old look. So this is a little project that you guys can do yourselves. So what I did was I went and bought some 1x6, which is actually 5.5 inches long, or 5.5 inches wide by 3/4 inch thick. I've got 1¼ inch screws to screw the two together. And I took and cut these into my 55-inch lengths that I need. And so now I'm going to cut the crossboards at 11¼. And then we're going to screw them together and we're going to stain them. So you kind of want to kind of follow along and we'll get started. First thing I'm going to do is mark the boards. I went through and marked them off an inch at 11¼ inches. So I'm going to mark them with my square.
It's Sweden. It's made in Sweden.
My bad. So, all right, we're going to place these up here. again, I'm not trying to be too precise because I want this to look old and rusty. That's the whole idea here. These are a coarse thread screw that is designed for outdoor use, so it won't rust. It's coated, so they're approved for decks and different things like that. You have to be smarter than the package to open it. Got to get the correct bit to put in this. Now again, I've got my lines lined up here. I want to be 11 and a quarter wide. Come down 9 inches from the top. Started in here so that we can get it lined up. Thank you. the sander, and we're going to lightly sand all the edges and get that all broke down on the edges, and then we'll stain them.
Thanks.
Okay, what we got is my good old Ryobi sander here. Take this thing out. It's got the Velcro plate on it, and it will hook to my shop vac, so when we're in an area where we have to really wash the dust, which is not the case right now in here, because everything's in here right now. But once we get the HVAC system going, we're going to have to wash dust in here. But Martin's Heating Air will be putting in the HVAC system just like they did over at the last project. And they're coming in a couple weeks to get that done. So we're going to be ready for that. Okay, so I'm going to just lightly sand over these edges because I want to kind of break them, break the edges off. So right now they're sharp. If you can see that, they're sharp and there's little pieces sticking out. So I just want to kind of lightly go over all of them. Get the idea. That's what we're trying to do. So we'll get these all finished up and then we'll show you how to stain them. Okay, so what I've got here is this is just a brand name, Thompson's Water Seal. This is for concrete, wood, just all kinds of surfaces. And I got gallons of this in an old house that we bought a few years ago. It's still good. So I use it for all kinds of stuff. This happens to have a slight tint in it. The can is kind of where you can't read it anymore, but the person who bought this had it tinted. So it will have just a little bit of a tint to it. So we kind of shook this around a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my throwaway brush, because this is an oil base, and you can, it says on right on there, you can use mineral spirits to clean your brushes. I don't do that. I just buy a throwaway brush, and we are going to put one of these up here. I'm going to do the backside first, which is here. says right on the can to let it dry for 48 hours, so that's what we'll do. We won't put them up until next week. I'm just going to take some of this, pour it on there, spread it out. I want it to soak in good on this Swedish-made wood here. Now you woodworkers that work around here in all these factories that wash this are going to just be freaking out on all this. But I got to tell you, I'm going for a look that will look like it's been here 100 years. That's what I'm trying to get out of it. So that's kind of what I'm doing. I know how to sand things down, how to make it look new, and how to build. But that's not what I'm doing here. We're going to flip it over to the front side. We're playing some good music on the radio now. Again, just getting it generally coated. What I'm really worried about, more than anything, is the UV on this wood. I want it to weather. I want it to look old. And that's why I just put this clear on here like this. Well, actually, it's got a tint to it, but it's pretty. You can see it's a little darker.
Okay, Rick's back here with the shutters that we built for the Mill Street property. And it's been 48 hours since we put the stain and UV protectant on them. They didn't turn out quite as dark as the other ones did. I think the reason is this is not treated lumber. This is just regular pine from Sweden. Or Switzerland or someplace, if I remember right. So anyway, we're going to get these put up, so I'll show you more. Okay, well, I guess the camera quit, so you didn't get to see me putting them up, but anyway, they're up now. They are a little lighter, but they've not been out in the sun yet, so this other wood is darkened up as the sun's been on it, so hopefully this one will too. So, that is all of the gut. All of the shutter project. Be sure to like and share if you liked this project. Share it with everyone so we can get it out there. Talk to you later. Thanks guys for watching. Bye. Run, Tallulah, run!
Hi, baby.